you for joining us at 6. I'm Julie Montanaro.
And I'm Jacob Murphy. Scars from those tornadoes still visible today throughout Tallahassee in many neighborhoods and in Railroad Square.
WCTV's Capital City correspondent Matt Hoffman is joining us live now to discuss. Matt.
Hey, good evening, Julie and Jacob. You know, supporters of Railroad Square tell me they're taking a breather. It was a literal whirlwind as some here who rented businesses had to leave within 2 days of those twisters rolling through. But just because they're taking a breather doesn't mean they're done fighting. Storms tearing across the Big Bend back in May, causing those like Terry Galloway, a Tallahassee resident heavily involved in theater, to flee her business. Railroad Square, a collection of business owners who rent in an art district heavily damaged by the storms. Supporters have been asking Tallahassee's commissioners to buy the property or at least invest in it. But 6 months on, Galloway says the tornadoes could be the final nail in the area's coffin, though she hopes not.
And everyone's talking about the revitalization of the South Side. Well, that's it. Right there, right in the middle. It has arts history, it has racial history, it has business history, it has all of this history. It's right downtown.
Wounds are still visible on FSU property at the Rec Sportsplex, but there is better news there. Despite demolished bleachers and better roofs, a university spokesperson tells us the area is operational once again. And just to give you an idea of the scale of all of this, FEMA says it has distributed more than $9 million in assistance. So it's quite a bit of money for our area across the Big Bend. Here in Tallahassee, I'm Matt Hoffman, WCTV Eyewitness News.
Yeah, our thoughts still with Indian Head Acres as well as Cactus Street, so many neighborhoods impacted 6 months ago. Thank you, Matt. Here's a more detailed breakdown of those FEMA dollars Matt mentioned. Of the $9 million in aid, almost $4 million went towards housing assistance, $5 million towards other needs, which can include transportation, childcare, even medical expenses. FEMA approved more than 3,000 applications for aid in the wake of those May 10th tornadoes.